Welcome to Chemistry Online Classes. Next topic is isoelectric point. Let's take amino acid general amino acid. And last class we have discussed that amino acid exists in the Jeter ion form. So the Jeter ion form is the amino acid is having equal number of opposite charges, 1 plus and 1 minus, and this form we call it as Jeter ion form. This is also called as internal salt. Now this amino acid I am taking into very low pH. What is the meaning of low pH here? It means I am taking into acidic condition. In acidic condition, CO minus carboxylate ion, which accepts H plus and which is converted into carboxylic acid, RCH COOH NH3 plus. Now at low pH, the Jeter ion is abstracting proton and it is converting into cation. So overall charge of this molecule is positive charge and this is called cation. Similarly, if I take it into high pH, so this is low pH, I am taking it to high pH. High pH means basic condition. Let us assume we are adding some base OH minus. What happened here? This NH3 plus, which will give proton, which is converted into NH2, RCH, COO minus, and which loses proton and convert into NH2. Overall charge on this molecule is negative charge. This is called as anion. So, from this data, I can clearly say that the Jeter ion formation is depend on pH value. So the Jeter ion form, it will depend on pH. If you take into low pH, high pH, one of the charges is nullified, other will be predominate. As a result, we can see cation formation, anion formation. And what is isoelectric point? Now isoelectric point is the pH at which amino acid exist in the form of Jeter ion is known as isoelectric point. That means the pH at which amino acid exists in the Jeter ion, that point we call it as isoelectric point. So that is nothing but isoelectric means both the charges are present, positive and negative. That is nothing but Jeter ion, and this we call it as isoelectric point. And most of the cases when we take a pH is 7, that we call it as neutral. But in this case of amino acid, it will change as isoelectric point. Isoelectric point need not to be a 7, sometimes it is greater than 7 or less than 7. Once we know the pK values of dissociation constant values of ammonium and acid, we can find out the isoelectric point. Let's take some example to calculate isoelectric point by knowing pK value. I am taking first example, alanine. COOH and NH3 plus. So here the acid dissociation constant COOH, this pK value is 2.34. And ammonium ion pKa value is 9.69. So once we know the pk values, we can find out the isoelectric point. That is, isoelectric point we write in the symbolic, similar like a pH, pi, this is indicates isoelectric point of amino acids and proteins, equal to pKa 1, let assume this is 1, this is 2, plus pKa 2 by 2, which will give you isoelectric point. Here, what is the pKa value? 2.34 plus 9.69 divided by 2. It is approximately around 12 by 2. We get a data of 6.02. So this is isoelectric point of alanine. Isoelectric point of alanine. By knowing the pK values of both the dissociation constants, we can calculate isoelectric point. Let's take some more example. Let's take basic amino acid lysine. And the structure of the lysine is CH2. So here pK value of acid is 2.18 and pK value of ammonium ion, which is next to the, which is attached to the alpha carbon, is pKa 8.95, and this is approximately 10.79. Here we have 3, but we have to take it 2, because in the case of acidic and basic amino acid, there is a several forms which is exist, only one form to another form which shows a deuterionic character, that we have to calculate. So it is like a, when we look at here, how we have to take for isoelectric point calculation when we have 3 pK values, we have to look at identical ionization groups, identical ionizable group. So here it is a COH is ionized, NH3 plus and NH3 plus. In these 3 cases, which are identical, NH3 plus and NH3 plus, these 2 pK values we have to consider for the isoelectric point. Now pi, isoelectric point of lysine, equal to pK of this one 8.95 plus 10.79 divided by 2, which gives isoelectric point of lysine. It is approximately 1098. The average will be there, 9.87. This is isoelectric point of lysine. This isoelectric point, it is depends upon the, like a side chain, it is need not be 7, as I told you. So it is depends upon the side chain, if the isoelectric point will vary with amino acid. So whenever the, by like a 3 pK values which are coming into the picture, always we have to look at the identical ionizable group and we can calculate the isoelectric point. The isoelectric point of lysine is 9.87. Let's take another example. Now I have taken, one is neutral amino acid, second one is basic amino acid. I am moving into acidic amino acid. So here I am giving glutamic acid. CH2 CH, so here also 3 ionizable groups are there, NH3. The pKa of acid is 2.19 and pKa of ammonium ion is 9.67 and acid is pKa 4.25. So here we have to calculate isoelectric point of glutamic acid, and here we have to look at the pKa for identical groups COOH, COOH. Previous case it is basic, ammonium ion is there, it is acidic amino acid, COOH, COOH. So pKa is 4.25 plus 2.19 by 2. It is approximately 4 and 2, 3.22. This is the pKa value of glutamic acid. And these are very useful when we are going for the separation of amino acid. So this is about the isoelectric point and calculation of isoelectric point by knowing the pKa values. Next, we are moving into electrophoresis method or electrophoresis. And this method is used for separation of amino acids. Amino acids from mixture. This method works based on their pi value, that is isoelectric point values. So this method work based on amino acid pi values, that is isoelectric points values, and we have discussed that amino acid, when we take it into acidic medium, basic medium, there is a positive cation formation, anion formation. So when we are taking a charged species, when we apply electric field, and we know that charged species is migrates, positive charge migrates to cathode and negative charge species migrates towards the anode, and neutral species remains same in the electric field. And this is the concept. By taking this concept, we will separate amino acid, and this method we call it as electrophoresis. Let's take example. I am taking the previous three amino acid. One is acidic amino acid, another one is basic amino acid, and one neutral amino acid. So how it is separated is, let's take a, we have a mixture of amino acids, that is lysine plus alanine plus we have glutamic acid. Glutamic acid. So we have total three amino acid. One is lysine, another one is alanine, and next one is glutamic acid. Glutamic acid. So what we have to do in the electrophoresis is, we have to take a paper. It is made up of cellulose acetate. And what I am doing, I am keeping mixture of amino acid mid of the paper, that is lysine and alanine and glutamic acid, which are three are present in the middle of paper. Now this I kept in the buffer solution. Let's take, I am using buffer 6 pH. So buffer solution pH is approximately 6. After keeping here, I am applying electric field. Let's take here, one is anode, another one is cathode. Let's take here negative, this is cathode, this is positive. Now what I am doing, I have taken a mixture of amino acid and I kept in the buffer solution, and I am applying electric field. So what happened here, I am using a buffer solution pH 6, and if you look at the isoelectric point of alanine Pi, approximately 6 0.2, and what is the isoelectric point of lysine, Pi is 9.87, and glutamic acid isoelectric point is 3.22, so which is having different isoelectric points. Now we are using a basic buffer 6, and we know that when we take alanine, the isoelectric point is 6 and the buffer solution pH is 6, and it cannot be developed any charges. That means it alanine only exists in the jitter ion form. So both positive and negative charges are associated in the alanine. But if you look at the lysine, our buffer solution pH is 6 and isoelectric point of lysine is higher. When we take a lysine here, the buffer solution pH is 6 and lysine is exist in the positive species, that is cationic form. And when it comes to glutamic acid, our buffer solution pH is 6 and this isoelectric point of glutamic acid is less, and glutamic acid exists in the anion, and here alanine is neutral. Now we have taken 3 in the mixture middle of the paper, and we have used a buffer solution 6. We have applied electric current, and current is passed through the paper. So what happened here, lysine will move towards the cathode, because cation migrates toward the negative charge side, and here we get lysine. And anion species, that is glutamic acid, is migrated towards the anode. Glutamic acid. And alanine remain same in this middle. So now lysine is here, glutamic acid is here, alanine is here. So we can separate these 3 amino acids by taking electrophoresis method. So this entire setup or entire method, we call it as electrophoresis method. So basically we are depending on isoelectric point. And isoelectric point means it will show which pH the jitter ion form is exist. If you change the pH value such that we can convert into anion and we can convert into cation, depends upon the situation, we can use and we can separate the amino acid. And this is one of the best method for amino acid, and not only amino acid, even proteins also we can separate by taking electrophoresis method. And here one is cation, one is anion. We can see some of the cases 2 cations also we can separate. Let's take some of the amino acid which is exist, both are cation, still we can apply electrophoresis method. And here both cation will migrate toward the cathode, but where the difference will come, the migration ability or speed will differ. Larger molecule move slowly compared with the lighter molecule, and based on that mobility we can separate amino acid. So this is about the electrophoresis. In today's class we have discussed about isoelectric point and its application in the electrophoresis method, that is separation of amino acid by electrophoresis method. Let's take 2 molecules and calculate isoelectric point of this amino acid. So the first one is glycine, and here I am giving pK values of acid 2.34, in the case of amine 9.60, and the second one aspartic acid and this is an example for acidic amino acid. Here I'm giving pKa of this acid is 1.88 pKa. Amine is 9.60. This carboxylic acid pKa is approximately 3.65. So these two problems you do homework. Thank you.